ResearchMedia.com. Now, back to Extreme Radio.
And that was a great spot with Eddie Money, Greg. I really enjoyed that. But right now, on the line with us, one of the Mob Wives, Greg. Well, you know we're big fans of the Mob Wives.
I love them. And I love, love, love.
Well, thank you so much, Joe.
Miss Love Majewski.
Thank you so much for the invitation to Fitness RX for Men. I was looking forward to coming on. I'm glad Joe got in touch with me. I appreciate it.
Oh, no.
And I can't believe I'm on with Eddie Money. Who doesn't love Eddie Money?
Oh, God, he was great.
We love what you said to us on the break. I think will be perfect to say on the air right now, because that was a fucking classic line. Go ahead, love.
Well,
you got to repeat that one.
Well, I said, Two Tickets to Paradise. Who doesn't love Two Tickets to Paradise? Many a lady has gotten laid to that song in my day.
Oh, yeah.
That was a song that was vacation tickets, even if it's just to Miami for the weekend. And that song, you were getting busy.
Oh, I love that song, too. I used to love I Think I'm in Love. You remember that song? I Think I'm in Love. You know? I can't sing that.
And what about, there was another one that he sang with the chick. I didn't know you guys were taking live call-ins tonight, too. Now,
sure.
Just getting live callers? Uh-oh, I'm scared.
Yeah, we take them later, because this way here we want to be able to talk to you so nobody else, so we can just, we take them.
Yeah, we don't like to interrupt the guests.
That's cool either
either
way. I don't care. That's cool either way. I love talking to everybody. You know me, I'm a blabbermouth. It's my whole business.
But you know what, love? I got to ask you. You and my girlfriend loved you on the show. We can't figure out what the hell happened. Is it controversial?
Well, you know what? I'm going to say something now. I don't want to just, like, take over your show and just run rampant. But you know what? I've been really quiet about this for a year.
Don't be quiet. Go.
I didn't say anything because, out of respect and out of basically contractual obligations. They had us all between a rock and a hard place. And as you could see, they punched some of the heavy hitters on the show, like, you know, friends of mine, by just kicking them right out the door for opening their mouth. But the truth of the matter is, if I'm going to be quite frank, I only signed for one season. And they intended to give me my own show, my own spot. I was never supposed to be a permanent fixture on Mob Wives. I signed for one season and that. And they weren't really honest with the public about that, because they never came out and said, oh, she's only here for one season. You know, they had intention of taking me elsewhere. So the whole hoopla or hype that was surrounded the fight with Carla and all this nonsense, that was completely produced, and it was intended to go that way. You know what I'm saying? There was no,
right.
People go, oh, she got fired for hitting Carla. No. I was told this is what I had to do. You know what I'm saying? That was never a factor, like that I'm such a loose cannon that I just went off and did whatever I wanted. That was never a factor. You know, after that blew up, I was so pissed off that I mean, could you imagine seven times you're filming and she don't show up? Who is she, Charlie Sheen? You know, I understand you're afraid you're going to get beat up, but, like, you're a nobody. I got to wait for you. Then the night of the party, they edited it down. They whittled it down to a toothpick. Okay?
Yeah.
They edited so much out that I was there for over 2 hours. Sitting in the back of the party alone. I came here, my cousin was sitting in the back. They kept this separate from where the party was, so I wasn't filmed for 2 hours. They made me stand outside for like 20 minutes in the freezing cold, okay? Then they bring us in, and they make me stand in the back of the room, and everyone's coming over to me. You know how, like, the producers in the background hyping it up. You know, this is your moment. What are you going to say to Carly? I said, I don't need to be pumped up. I know what I want to say to her. Well, after over 2 hours of sitting there, they finally bring me into the party. Everybody's smashed. Everybody's drunk. Everybody's been having a good time. And they're all saying, why were you sitting in the back ignoring us? Meanwhile, what you, the viewers, and the public see is me walk into the party, come in, throw a fit, hit her, and walk out. I've been sitting there for hours, and no one knows that.
Wow.
You know?
Yeah, because
so,
on the clip, it looks like as soon as you guys see each other, you start wailing.
Yeah, exactly, and that's totally the furthest thing from the truth. And there were so many other factors to it, like the issue about me talking about my, about her taking the logo from my company. She, in the plaza where her ex-father-in-law set up this business, downstairs there's a store beneath it that sells my product and has the logo on it. She went in that store 2 weeks prior, and they had her on the security tapes that I had the video of her picking up my products and looking at them. And then next thing you know, bam, she's got this logo up on the window upstairs. I mean, my boyfriend drew it for me. I've got it tattooed on my wrist. You think I would tattoo it on my wrist if it was just come out of the blue? You know?
Right.
So they really did a butcher job on me, and that's why I walked out on the rest of it. Thank God that, you know, there's other producers I worked with, like when I did, you know, ID is a great channel. All the Discovery networks are great, and I loved working with them. So,
I love,
you know,
ID.
I stayed in good standing with the people from I Married a Mobster and from Deadly Sin. So they, when I walked off the show, they were already on the phone before I even got to the car. They were calling me. They had all different shows lined up for me. They had me shooting different sizzle reels. So they've got all kinds, and there's so many ideas coming in. Right now, it's just a matter of they say, okay, she can do anything. What should we make her do? And that's what they always say to me. They're like, you're funny on your own. You're funny with your mother. They like you dating. They like you with your friends. They want to see what you do with the makeup business, but we don't know which, you know, what to see of what of. So I don't really know what's going to happen next. I've filmed about 9 sizzle reels in the past year. I mean, that's like crazy. Nobody does that much work. And for people, you know, your listeners may not know, a sizzle reel is kind of like a pilot before it goes to the net, you know, to sell to the networks. It's almost a little slice of a show for them to see if they like it. So I've been working nonstop ever since I left Mob Wives. Just it hasn't been anything that we really felt was like the perfect team. You know what I mean? It was great. I had a good dynamic with, you know, with Karen and with Rita and with some of the other girls. But they got a bad break. They really did not. I would love it if Karen would come on your show and talk to you. But she has been vocal about going on other radio shows and saying, listen, they gave Love a raw deal. She said, I was in meetings where they told Love, if you don't hit caller, you're going to be off the show. And she said it openly. You know, and meanwhile, people, I was getting hate mail. I got 300 hate mails in one day. People telling me you should kill yourself. I'm like, listen, if I watched a TV show and I sat down, I went to the expense to look somebody up online and try to find them Twitter or Facebook or whatever and tell them that they should kill themselves because they cursed at somebody that I don't even know, then I should kill myself.
You're right. I mean, people don't understand.
You're looking
a lot
for
of
me,
stuff
pal.
That, you know,
I'm worried about you.
What you see is not what you get when you watch, you know, and I mean, they don't realize what goes on. I've been on a lot of shows myself, and
mm-hmm,
I mean,
mm-hmm.
Get about the whole sizzle reel thing. Holy shit, I know that deal. You know what I mean?
Let me tell you something. What I really wish that people would realize, I would love to write a book that's like the reality behind reality. I would love to do that.
Because you should do that. That sounds awesome.
The simplest thing, like continuity, here's an example. If you go back and watch season 3, you'll see me walking across the room and my shirt suddenly turns blue. How did that happen? That's not the same day, friend. That's not the same day. The shirt is not magic. It's not the same day. You know what I mean? But people don't realize that there's filming and refilming and edits, and they think that what they're seeing, they take it so to heart, you know? And sometimes you've got to just use your common sense. I had one fan who was so on point. This kid, I'll tell you, whoever she is, she's a genius. I wish she would have wrote to me again. She was about 14, and she said to me, what I don't understand is if your birthday is in November, and Drita's birthday is at this time of the year, and this one's birthday is at, how come they filmed, they showed this, this, and this, and she realized the timeline was wrong.
Mm-hmm.
I said, wow, at 14, she already got it all figured out. You're going to be all right, kid. You're going to do good in life.
Hey, now, Love, do you think that what happened with you between Carla and Jen and obviously Renee and his her sister, do you think that they kind of blackballed you, you think?
Well, you know what? I still speak to Jen here and there. I don't have any problems with her, you know. Mm. Renee, if anything, Renee is, in my opinion, Renee is the biggest snake that there ever was, a backstabber, a traitor. I mean, I can't even tell you. And she was never even really friends with half these people, like distant relations. Now, all of a sudden, she's got this crew out of Philly that nobody ever met before. The girl's not that friendly. All of a sudden, you got a million friends all over the community.
Yeah, you're right.
The thing is, she pushed
that.
Me gung-ho. You know, she was the one who pulled me on the side and said to me, listen, you know, Carl is going through this crew, and she's abusing everybody. Look what she did to Ramon. Look what she did to Karen. You know, Karen's your girl. How are you going to let this go on? And she's gone unchecked, and look what she said to me. She said, and if anybody's going to go in and say something, it should be you, because you're the one that cleans up, and, like, you're the one that handles this, and you should really make it a point to, like, put her in her place. and gave me these long speeches over and over and over again about how I needed to help her out because she was weak because she was in recovery and she needed help and all this. And really, really was, you know, I felt that day that I was really going to bat for her more than anybody because she was the one who really was weak and you know, helpless. And when I heard afterwards that she ran and was putting ice on her hand and was laughing. Do you know that her son came over and shook my hand and said to me, thank you, stick it up for my mother before I left the party, yet she's putting ice on her hand. You phony bitch. Who are you kidding with that? She set that up. You know what I'm saying? She set that up for her own gain. But she was jealous of me from day one. I got calls from, you know, from people that work in production that as soon as my numbers would go higher than hers in any way, shape, or form, she would be screaming that she wanted me off the show. Like, she's so jealous. I've never seen a human being like that. The only thing I got to say for her is that it's got to be so horrible to live inside her own mind, living in her body. You know, when you're a jealous person like that or envious, nothing makes you happy. Nothing's ever good enough, and nothing ever makes you happy. Me, I'm happy for all my friends. And, you know, I look at it like this. I was talking to Karen yesterday. I said, you know, the best part is that she's getting to spend more time with her daughter. Her book was successful. A lot of this did a lot of purging for us of stuff that was in our lives that we couldn't talk about.
Yeah.
You know, right. Stuff that we were never able to get out. It was almost like therapy, but like a condensed, concentrated form of therapy, you know. And now I'm getting to work on so many exciting things. You know, I have Veritas Cosmetics at veritascosmetics.com, mm-hmm. And I've also been working with a couple of other companies that you know, on promotional things. I fell in love with this product from ulaces.com and Juiced Watches. I got all kinds of fun stuff going on, and people coming to me and saying, you know, we like your style, we like the way you do things or what you represent, you know, being bold, not taking shit, not getting bullied, not getting picked on, not being pushed aside. So like you said about blackballed, you're only blackballed if you let people blackball you. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I feel like, do they try to push me out? Yeah, but of what? They push me out of Mob Wives? I never agreed to stay with Mob Wives longer than one season.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So it really, behind the scenes, the decision is, what pissed me off was that I see there's an interview going around with Jennifer where she's saying that we asked for more money. I didn't ask you for nothing. She said, well, all those girls were released from the show because they asked for more money. The problem is that anytime anybody would go to her with any kind of idea, like, listen, I got a great idea, like, you know, like I just said, this company with these watches, this company with this, it's a great idea. They want us to work with us, or they want to put us on something. All of a sudden, the next day, you'd hear Renee had a deal with them, and none of you would ever hear from them again.
Mm. Right.
You know, and of course, we all know this. This is, you know, that's how it's going to go. But how many times could you stab people in the back before, you know, the knife is sticking out of your neck and you're saying, and this one, I know how it got here. It's right in my front. You can only stab somebody in the back so many times before you run out of room and you're stabbing them in the front. You know what I meant to say?
You run out of holes. We got about 2 minutes left, so I want to make sure we get all the plugs out there. You just mentioned Veritas Cosmetics.
Okay.
It's Veritas Cosmetics.
VeritasCosmetics.com. But listen, most importantly, what I want to say is I'll be pushing for you guys, but they're running right now. I have the greatest social media manager and a really great team behind me. They're running trivia every week on anything you've got, Instagram, Vine, what do you call it, Facebook, Twitter. So every single week they run a trivia game with 10 questions about me, and you get to win a prize. And those prizes are now promotions of whatever company, whatever product I like, autographed pictures, phone calls from me. It's a lot of fun. We're having a good time with it. And it's a way to keep up with whatever's going on with me, you know, whatever projects I'm working on are on there. So whatever social media you're on, just look up Love Majewski, and you will find me on my own name. So whether it's Facebook, Twitter, you know, trivia, anything, anything at all, just look up my name and look my, you know, me directly through my name.
Yeah,
so,
definitely.
And again, VeritasCosmetics.com, that's my baby, that's my company that I, you know, originated, and I'll always, you know, have there. And, oh, another, I want to throw a shout out to Long Beach Rocks. My girlfriend Cheryl today is celebrating jewelry. She's celebrating today her anniversary of having her own company. That's a big thing. And what else? What else? What else? Oh, of course, we're going to send a shout out to all my friends and family, my sweethearts, and on Facebook for supporting me. I just want to thank them all.
All right, that is awesome. So make sure
and
you check out Love Majewski.
I will definitely I will plug for you guys because I had a great time with you tonight.
Oh,
I can't wait to give you a segment of Steady Money.
Yo.
All right. Oh, and I will put Karen in touch with you boys too.
Yeah,
I want
I'll
her to
talk
tell
to
you the
tomorrow,
same thing.
And we'll get the ball rolling.
She's funny as hell. You'll love it.
Love
all right,
so
guys. Thanks so much for reaching
thank
out.
You love
it was a ball.
We love
thank
love.
You.
Had a great time.
I love
stay in touch. And when I have my next project, I'll be happy to come back and tell you all about it. When I
we're in New York, I'm going. We should all get together.
Love to have you back on. I love Jim Majewski from the Mob Wives. We'll be right back.